I'll be just a few minutes. I'm the general manager of Divvy, Chicago Bike Share System. We were here about a year ago for our first Divvy Data Challenge, which we just launched. And we had about 6 months worth of data. We launched in June of 2013, and I was here, I think, last January or February. We did this the first time. I'm here to announce that we're going to do the Divvy Data Challenge for the second year in a row. And what that is we're releasing 3.2 million trips of anonymized, or 3.2 million anonymized trips that have been taken since our launch. So they're on our website, divvybikes.com/data-challenge. You can find out all the details. And what we're doing is we're encouraging the developer community, data scientists, designers to take all that data or take parts of that data and visualize it in an interesting way, whether it's an infographic or an app or a website or a video, whatever it may be, and come up with something interesting to show. So I just want to talk a little bit about Divvy. We have 3.2 million trips so far. That's split between members and 24-hour pass holders. And this is all in the data set, and I'll go through the specifics of what's there. 6.7 million miles traveled, and we're currently at 300 stations. This year, we're going to be expanding to 475 stations. So right now, we have about a year and a half pass worth of data on the website for you to play with and hack and just have fun. This year, we have 3.2 million trips. The deadline to submit is March 20th, so it gives you about a month to play with it. And there'll be winners chosen in a variety of categories. So we're looking for the most beautiful one, the most insightful one, the most creative, lots of different ways to express yourself. And the winners get a Microsoft hardware and software package, the details of which will be announced shortly. And we're also going to take out a full page ad in the red eye to announce the winners at the end of March or early April. The data itself is pretty basic. So it's the trip start day and time, trip end day and time, the station name for the beginning and end of the trip, whether that person was a member, whether they're a 24-hour pass holder. And if they're a member, what we have is also data on their gender as well as their year of birth. So it's a pretty simple data set, and I think that that's good if you're a beginner. This is a great data set to play with and maybe do your first project. But if you're advanced as well, there's some really interesting things you can do. This is the webpage. You can go to divvybikes.com/data-challenge. And I just want to run briefly through last year's winner just to give you a flavor of some of the things that people have created with the data. Last year was only 750,000 trips, so this year there's a lot more to play with. But here is the overall winner that combined beauty, insight, comprehensiveness, and creativity. As you can see, there's a lot of, you can't see the specifics, but there's a lot of different ways they express the data in terms of the trip by day, the most popular stations. You can see it visualized in a map. People also talk about the times of day, you know, when trips peaked and when they dipped. Really interesting expressions in this one. You can also check this out on the website. In terms of most creative, this is also probably the most creepy. It's a Divvy dating site where you can say who you're looking for, if you're looking for a man or a woman, what age, what neighborhood, and it will tell you the Divvy station to go to and what time of day to check it out to have the highest likelihood of finding that mate. So some call it creepy, we call it a career. Another creative winner was this one, which put the Divvy trips to sound. So you could select certain stations and it would play the day and there'd be a sound for every trip taken from one of those stations throughout the day. You can also check this out. Most comprehensive, you can zoom in on this if you go to our website, but you can see a really interesting expression that combines, these are neighborhoods listed here, it's all the time of the day, weekdays and weekends, so it really differentiates lots of different ways to slice the data, and looks very cool too. And then finally, most insightful, this was more of like a paper, but with really interesting charts and talked about some of the patterns in terms of, you know, people using this as a couple, are people using this in pairs, are using it alone, you know, what kinds of routes are they going to, and it was a little more analytical as opposed to visual, but really interesting stuff, and again, this is all available on the website. So I promise I wouldn't take too much of your time. I guess if you do have questions, these guys probably have some good answers afterwards as well. Steven, you want to say something?
who entered last year into the challenge? There were 99 submissions.
99 submissions, yeah.
Every year?
Wow.
Wow.
Okay, so they must all be at home right now.
Yeah.
So I run the transportation breakout group, but we have a big project that we're working on. So I don't have any, I'm not going to be spending time on Divvy challenge or to help you get to speed, but I do have resources from last year that I helped that I put together that should get you jump started on entering this year's competition. And so we'll be, those will be on our Google group, and also there are other ways you can also find me on Twitter. But it would be awesome if someone in the next 30 minutes thought that they wanted volunteers to be a Divvy breakout group for the next month and a half. So give that some thought. We'll ask you again in 30 minutes.
All right, so tweet at us, email us. There's data@divvybikes.com if you have any questions. But thanks for giving me the time and hope the challenge. Thank you.